Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Good evening. It's Lynn Turner and Highbury. I came here for one purpose and one purpose alone. And that's to lift up the name of Jesus Christ. You may have heard of his name before, but I came here to let you know that Jesus Christ is the Savior of the world. He's the soon coming King. And if you don't know Jesus Christ, today is the greatest day to believe in Jesus Christ and be saved. Hallelujah. The Bible says there's no other name given among men by whom we shall be saved but the name of Jesus. Jesus Christ came to die on the cross for the sins of the world, that the world shall be free, that the world shall be that the world shall receive salvation, meaning rescued from sin. Hallelujah. And some people say you're perfect, but if I ask you a question, have you stolen before? Have you stolen something before? It doesn't matter how big or how small. You say yes. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter how what kind of lie you've told. It's still a lie. And I came to tell you today that nobody's perfect except for Jesus Christ, and He wants to have a relationship with you so that you shall be perfect in Him and not by your own works. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. I came to tell somebody today that Jesus Christ is calling you today that you shall become a child of the Most High God, that you shall have a place in eternity. Jesus Christ said in my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I wouldn't have told you I'm going to prepare a place for you, that where I am you but also. Jesus Christ is calling you to the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. And the Bible says that the devil comes to kill, steal, and to destroy. But Jesus Christ came to give us life and more abundantly. And I came to tell you today, you can experience a glorious life in Jesus Christ. You can experience life to the full in Jesus Christ. Some people have said, oh, going to church is boring. I don't know what church you're going to, but my church is a church on fire. My church is a church that knows Jesus Christ and Him crucified. Some people have said that church is boring. I can tell you something, ladies and gentlemen, when you know Jesus Christ, hallelujah. Oh, it's like an action movie. I came to tell you something. He heals the sick, He raises the dead. Oh, He sets the captives free. The blind begins to see, the cripple begins to walk. That's the kind of God I serve. And if you're sick and nobody come, and I can pray with you today, because I believe my Jesus Christ is a healer. Oh yes, I came to tell you today that Jesus Christ is a healer. And I believe Islington and Highbury, it's time to believe in Jesus Christ. I believe it's time that the United Kingdom turns back to God. I believe it's time that this nation will humble themselves and turn to God once again. I believe when this nation returns to God, things will begin to change. I believe when this nation returns back to the true living God, things shall begin to change in the United Kingdom for good. Jesus Christ says that we should love the Lord our God with all our hearts and all our minds and all that's within us. We should love our neighbor as ourselves. And I can, let me tell you something. When you love God with your heart, when you love God with your all, and if you love your neighbor as yourself, surely there shall be a better society than what we have today. But if you look in today's society, we see so many people fighting one another, killing one another. We see so many people addicted to drugs because they're trying to satisfy an emptiness that they have in their lives.
In the name of faith.
Let me tell you something. This man said fighting one another in the name of faith. Let me tell you something. You know, Jesus Christ, God has told us that we shouldn't kill, you know. And that's, you know, a person that fights in the name of Jesus is not a Christian. A Christian is a person that does not kill. A Christian is a person that is filled with the Holy Spirit and fire. A Christian is a person that loves God. A Christian is a person that knows God. Christian is a person that loves to have a relationship with God, that spend times with God. A Christian is a person that does good. A Christian is a person that cannot lie. A Christian is a person that doesn't have sex outside of marriage. A Christian is a person that knows God. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. A Christian is a person that is filled with the Holy Ghost and fire. A Christian is a person that knows the devil's lies. That is who a Christian is. Hallelujah. A Christian is not a confused person. A Christian is not a confused person. But we live in today's society whereby there's so many people living in this life are so confused. No direction in life. The Bible says that broad is the way that leads to destruction. Broad is the way that leads to destruction. And many people are walking on the broad way that leads to destruction. Islington, are you walking on the broad way that leads to destruction? Have you given your life to Jesus Christ? Do you know your purpose? Do you know where you're going in life? Because surely some of you, you think you go 9 to 5, you got a job. So that is life. That ain't life. Life is not having a 9 to 5. That's a miserable life. A miserable life is having a job from 9 to 5. I don't even like your job. Some of you, you don't even like your job. You just go because you just need money. But let me tell you something. When you got Jesus Christ in your life, it is supernatural. When you got Jesus Christ in your life, it's like an action movie. When you got Jesus Christ in your life, He satisfies your life. He satisfies your soul. I can tell you, ladies and gentlemen, oh my God. I remember at the age of 17, I was able to spend about £600 a month. But that did not satisfy me. I was trying to please my friends. I was trying to be in the group. But let me tell you something, ladies and gentlemen, no money can satisfy. No money can satisfy. And some people think that money is the answer to life. But guess what? The many rich people in the hospital, wishing they can come out of the hospital bed. They got all the money, but yet they're still in the hospital. It tells me that money is not the answer to life. So many people are dependent on money. An aimless life without God. An aimless life. An aimless life. Oh yes. Because, you know, one day we shall surely die, won't we? Everybody will die someday. And that's the truth. Everybody one day will have to stand before God. Some people have said, oh, God is not real. God. Oh my goodness me. It just makes me laugh, you know. Why? Because when you got a relationship with God, you know the truth. The other day I was speaking to a Satan worshiper, and he was just talking. He doesn't believe in God, and I'm thinking, if you don't believe in God, why are you a Satan worshiper in the first place? You see, the reason why we believe in God is because He gives us an understanding of life. The reason why we believe in God is because He sent Himself through Jesus Christ to die for our sin. The reason why we believe in God is because there's hope in Him. There's life in Him. The God kind of quality kind of life. Where there's nothing missing, nothing broken in your heart. You see, some years ago I used to be homosexual because I was looking for love in my... I was looking for loving men. But let me tell you something. That did not satisfy. I was so addicted to pornography. Oh my God. But that did not satisfy. But when Jesus came into my life. When Jesus came into my life, He set me free. And I have the greatest relationship. Experiencing an unconditional love. That goes beyond race and color. Oh my God, the love that is in Jesus, is beyond description. Words are not enough to describe the love of God. And when you have the love of God in your life, hey, what else matters? What else matters when you got God in your life? What else matters is when you got a relationship with God? What else matters? Even in this time when there's so many things going on, you know that you can face tomorrow. Why? Because your trust is not in money, your trust is not in the government, but your trust is in Jesus. There's a difference. When you put your trust in Jesus, the Bible says He'll never fail you. He'll never disappoint you. Jesus Christ cannot fail. I remember the days when I used to be a homeless person, when I used to wake up 5 a.m. in the morning just to have a bath at the back of the shelter. I remember the days when I used to cry at night without food to eat. I remember the days when I used to be jobless. I remember the days when I wanted to kill myself so many times. I remember the days when I had a heavy cloud of depression on my head and I couldn't even think straight. But I know that today I'm standing here today as a child of the Most High God. I stand here today because of Jesus. I may not be the most intelligent person. I may not be the richest person on the planet. But one thing I know, Highbury, Islington, that there's a name called Jesus. There's a name called Jesus that changes and transforms lives. There's a name called Jesus that does the impossible. There's a name called Jesus that when you really come to him, that when you really call upon the name of Jesus, things begin to change. When you really call upon the name of Jesus, the blind shall see, the crippled shall walk, the dead shall come, the dead shall hear again, the dead shall come back to life. When you really come to Jesus Christ, there is a difference. Hallelujah. Yes. Hey, my God, he gets me bubbling to my feet. Hey, Jesus gets me bubbling to my feet. I don't know who gets you bubbling to your feet, but Jesus gets me bubbling to my feet. Jesus gives me joy. Jesus gives me hope. Jesus gives me peace. Jesus gives me love. Jesus Christ is more than what you know, ladies and gentlemen. I gotta tell you, United Kingdom, it's the name of Jesus. Yeah, 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 yeah. It's the name of Jesus. The Bible says, taste and see that the Lord is good. We have tasted and we have tried that Jesus is good. The same way when you go to McDonald's, you gotta try a burger, don't you? You gotta try a burger if it tastes nice or not. You know, you go to McDonald's and then you have a Big Mac and you gotta taste the Big Mac, don't you? And if the Big Mac is not delicious, what do? You spit it out, don't you? But when you come to Jesus Christ and you taste Jesus, when you taste Jesus, my God, oh, there's a certification in Jesus. There's a certification in Jesus Christ. That is beyond description. That is beyond comparison. You cannot compare Jesus Christ to no other. You cannot compare Jesus Christ to no religion. You cannot compare Jesus Christ to nobody. He's above anybody. Come on, somebody. Jesus Christ is above every religion. Can I tell you? Can I tell you that Jesus Christ is above any religion? Oh, yes. Jesus Christ is greater than any religion. Do you know that? Do you know that Jesus is greater than any other religion? Jesus Christ is greater than the Pope of Rome. Jesus Christ is greater than the government that you put your trust in. The government will fail you every time and time again. Every single time you vote. you vote. What happens? You get disappointed. That is why it's time you gotta pray for this nation. You gotta pray for the United Kingdom. You gotta pray to God that God will have a nation that fears God, that have a government that fears God. Hallelujah. When a nation turns away from God, there is chaos. Didn't you see in Parliament there was chaos? They don't even know what they're doing. But when you pray for this nation and you begin to say, God, help this nation, help this government, something begins to change. Why? Because God answers prayer. God answers prayer. Oh, London, God answers prayer.